Yo, this is Deontay the Bronze Bomber Wilder, the WBC heavyweight champion of the world. And I'd like to give a big shout out to CJ Goodfella on Sports TV. Bomb Squad, baby.
Don't forget to check out our sponsor, The Hellblaze, at thehellblaze.com. 100% all natural products from lotions, soaps, foot soaks, bath bombs, and much, much more. Use the promo code Goodfella1Boxing. Tell them your boy CJ Goodfella sent you, get 18% off. We out. All right, man. Got some news here. Shout out to Mike Coppinger for dropping this one. Maurice Hooker has been granted his release from Matchroom and Rock Nation. This is like the second fighter that Matchroom and dropped. They also dropped Michael Hunter. But the good thing is Maurice Hooker has signed a deal with Premier Boxing Champions, and I'm pretty sure he's going to make his welterweight debut pretty soon. I believe they say in the fall, so let's talk about it. Hit that subscribe button, bell icon button, share the video. Are they going to revive Regis and Hooker talks? That's a good question, but kind of talk about how you fit in at PBC and what's going on at Rock Nation and The Zone and Matchroom. Make sure hit that subscribe button, bell icon button, share the video. And it seems that Eddie Hearn is, you know, same thing that they're doing with Canelo. The Zone don't have the money to retain people. They don't have the money to put these fights on anymore. So they'd rather release these dudes than, put them in fights that's not going to bring a return. And I told y'all, nobody watching The Zone, even when Canelo fight, Golovkin fight, they not doing good numbers because it's the era of digital streaming. All right? I can get the same quality streaming as I get on The Zone, really. They're not bringing nothing different like boxing in 4K or 3D boxing. It's the same ass shit I get on my computer or my Fire Stick. But here's Coppinger. Maurice Hooker has agreed to terms with PBC on a multi-fight deal after securing the release from Matchroom and Rock Nation. Sources tell The Athletic the former 140-pound champion will make his pro debut, or make his PBC debut in this fall. And, they just don't have the money no more. Rock Nation, I can't believe they even still doing business in boxing, to be honest. Who they really got? They got, like guys that's, you know, really got co-promotional contracts with other, you know, companies and stuff of that nature. And it's just time for Jay to get out the business. Excuse me, because there ain't no room for him. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, to be honest, if Maurice Hooker go to 47, I mean, you know, once again, PBC is just, you know, going back to monopolizing the 147-pound division. They got top dogs, they got middle-tier dogs, they got bottom dogs, they got the old dogs. They got the Earls, the Thurmans, the Pacquiao's right now, the Sean Porters, the Danny Garcias. He's a middle contender, then the Ugases, and, you know, guys of that nature. Omar Figueroa, you go down, they got the guys like Maurice Hooker, they got the, you know, it's all type of guys. They got the bottom feeder, old dogs, Berto, Victor Ortiz, Robert Guerrero. They just cover the board, and, you know, that's what Al Heyman got to do. Al Heyman really slipping in a lot of other divisions. 40 is, you know, really up for grabs. That top rank really got it right now, but once they fight Josh Teddy Ramirez, then, you know, that's up for grabs. And then he got 54 on lock. He lost 68 thanks to David Benavidez. 75, he ain't got that division. All the champions with his own or with top rank. The heavyweight division, he lost that. Bob Arum just started monopolizing that division. So Al Heyman really ain't got too many divisions. 30, he ain't got. 26, he really ain't got no more. 35 is up for grabs and stuff of that nature. So to be honest, you know, 47, 54, excuse me, and possibly 160 is really all Al Heyman really can get at this point. But as far as Hooker, you know, who could he fight? I mean, he going to have a soft touch coming in. You know what I'm saying? But they got good fights. You know, him in a Texas fight with him and Omar Figueroa would be good. You know what I'm saying? Him and Regis, once Regis, you know, is supposed to tune up this year too. And then fight Adrian Broner down the line. Broner beat Ivan Redcash in December. Sean Porter still there. Keith Thurman still there. You just got a lot of guys that's there. Him in a fight, him and Errol Spence. I don't think Errol Spence is really on his radar at this point. Jamal James. Josito Lopez. They just got a lot of different opponents for him to really get after, and I don't know exactly what their aim is for him as far as what they kind of want to build him into, or what was their purpose of bringing him on. But to be honest, Eddie Hearn is slipping. You know, that Zone bag is kind of running out, and The Zone is running on fumes. You know, I'm not hoping that The Zone fall off, but I think it'd be good for boxing if it's just two powerhouses there. That was the idea when HBO left the game, that, you know, now Showtime and Fox and PBC and ESPN Top Rank, they got to make the best fights out there. And then The Zone came in here throwing a large amount of money at fighters. And then, you know, they just created more complications. But as far as Hooker, you know, I don't know really who he can beat. He probably can, you know, him and Omar Figueroa would be a barn burner. You know what I'm saying? Not sure he can 100% win that fight. Him and Ugas, you know, that could be a barn burner. Not 100% sure he can win that fight. Shit, Berto, he probably can win. Him and Josito would be a good fight. Marcos Madonna is always is supposedly on his way back down to that weight as well. You know, he won't be a Pacquiao fight. I don't think he won't get an Earl fight. But really, you know, I'm surprised that Bob Arum didn't kind of get at Hooker. But obviously, Hooker and Crawford wasn't going to fight. So that really didn't probably make mathematical sense for him. But like I said before, this is a shakeup. I think Eddie Hearn is just, you know, don't be surprised if Demetrius Andrade is another guy that don't get released. Danny Jacobs' contract about to run out. And I was just thinking and hearing he may be going back to PBC to possibly fight like Caleb Plant, maybe Jamal Charlo if he get past Rosado. So Eddie Hearn roster might be getting slimmer in Matchroom USA, and it might get to the point where it may not be no more Matchroom USA. It may just be Devin Haney Promotions and Eddie Hearn, you know, because really ain't none of his American fighters bringing a return. And that's the issues, you know what I'm saying? Golovkin taking $14 million plus equity, you know, or weak equity, and what is he doing? So I think the Zone is in the process of cleaning the house. I think they didn't, once Regis and Maurice Hooker fell out, and they was looking at, you know, Regis probably was looking to get a lesser fight. Maurice Hooker was looking to get a lesser fight. And the Zone said, nah, you know, y'all can go ahead about y'all business. We don't want them back. So the Zone is in a position where, you know, I don't know what they really think about having Callum Smith, you know, fight Canelo going to do. It'll do good for, you know, the $5 subscription that they're going to break open with the Zone UK. But they ain't going to do nothing in America. I think the Zone is slowly moving out of America. I think they understand that they can't win here. You know what I'm saying? That boxing fan, that casual fans don't care about an app with boxing. They need more. They need NFL. They need tennis. They need golf. They need hockey. They need, you know, Netflix or like sports movies. And the Zone just ain't got the resources or the finances to get there. And I think, you know, when you see more and more fighters start to buy themselves out and leave Matchroom and leave Golden Boy, and they start going to PBC and Top Rank because Eddie Hearn was supposed to sign Josh Taylor, and Bob Arum swooped in and stole him. So I just think it's at that you know, that point. But maybe they'll think about doing Regis and Maurice Hooker down the line. You know, that's the $1 million question. Maybe they do that. You know, maybe if Hooker, you know, get past what they got for him and, you know, Regis get past his tune-up, past AB, maybe Regis and Hooker can do it at 47 or whatever. But, I mean, Regis got a lot of options. You know, Robert Jr., you know, Mario Barrios, the dude that had a close fight with Barrios last time out. He got just a tremendous amount of options at 140. I mean, I don't know why he would move up to 147 unless it was for a title or a title eliminator or a big fight. But Hooker going to 47, really, this is a move that's going to be, I don't think he could survive up there, to be honest. I mean, I think you could put him in the middle of the pack. You know, maybe he get Danny on his way out, but maybe get Danny a good fight. Maybe get Ugas a good fight. Maybe get Omar a good fight. But he can easily lose to all of those dudes. You know what I'm saying? Maybe him and Granados can fight. I mean, you got some options up there. You know, Zito, Berto, Victor Ortiz just called out Amir Khan. I mean, Oscar De La Hoya. I mean, he got some options. They really cover the board at PBC at the welterweight division. They got the top dogs, the middle tier dogs, the bottom dogs, and they got the old dogs. You know, so we'll see what Hooker, you know, pretty much, you know, lie in that scenario. But I don't expect to see him hold one of the major four belts. I don't. If you got issues with Jose Ramirez, Sean Porter, Thurman, all those dudes going to be tough for him to fight. But maybe Bomac can show some improvements in him, add some toolage to his game, add some tools to his game. He could do it. But hopefully, you know, him and, you know, Regis Full Progress can do it and they could be on Fox or FS1 or something like that, and they can really get their just do on a bigger platform. But I think the Zone is kind of scaling back, and we see that. You know, I think the Zone is pretty much like, you know what, we're going to cut the fat. You know what I'm saying? They may cut this shit all the way together because them and Canelo having issues, and their legal teams are talking it out. So, you know, this should be interesting. You know, really, really interesting, man. And I really don't know what Eddie Hearn going to do. I think Eddie Hearn going to go back to the UK, beg Sky, get on his knees and go back doing what he going to do. But obviously the plan to take over America, it was going to be a disaster. It was going to plummet regardless. But I think the pandemic sped that up a bit. So congratulations, Maurice Hooker, for getting that PBC bag. Hopefully in some great fights. Hopefully, you know, he get everything he want, world titles and bags and monies and Hall of Fame status. And they got, you know, Maurice and Regis, so maybe they could do that fight. But hey, don't forget, we on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Reach out if you have a business question, inquiry, sponsorship, video request. Keep sharing the videos. Want to make a donation? Cash App, CJ Good 313. PayPal link in the description. Shout out to my boy Ed for donating earlier today. Appreciate the love, support. Best way to donate is to share the video one time for the one time. It's your boy CJ Goodfella. And check our boxing news playlist for more videos like this. We gone.